Have you thought about downsizing the number of cleaning products that you're using? Hi, I'm Bernice Hunt, and I am a brain health specialist. I work with women just like you who are starting to notice a few memory challenges, and I help you to stay sharp so that as you age, you can still travel, have fun with your grandkids, and experience new adventures without missing a beat. As a wellness coach for over 12 years, I've done a lot of talking about nutrition. But you know what? What you put in your mouth is not the only way that toxins get into your body. Now, did you catch my last video? I did a video a few days ago, and it was talking about the different entryways that toxins come in. Because it's not just through your mouth. So if you didn't catch that, you can go ahead and look at that video. It's on my YouTube channel, and it's also on my Facebook page, Keep Your Brain Sharp. But today I wanted to talk about rethinking what you're using to clean your house and your body. Because you want to think about what's connecting to your skin and what you're smelling. And even what your eyes are being exposed to, because those are all entryways. It's not just your mouth. It's also your eyes, your nose, your skin. Toxins can get in that way. Now, I'm not saying that everything you put on your skin is going to go get absorbed and go into your body, because our skin is our first line of defense. You know, it's that first barrier, and its job is to keep things out, to keep out stressors and irritants and that kind of thing. But our skin is not invincible. And you know what? The more exposure it gets, the more you continue to put things on your skin, you can weaken its ability to keep things out, and also you can do harm to it. So it's really important that you try to limit those harsh products, because the more you put on for prolonged periods of time, the harder it's going to be for your skin to do the job that needs to do. And your goal should be not just to help your brain and give your brain the things it needs, but also to not hurt your brain by presenting it with things that it does not need that will actually do it damage, okay? So today I want to talk about that, because when you put things on your skin, when you smell things through your nose and whatever, it causes an irritant, which can go and lead on to stress, which can lead to inflammation. And we all know that when it gets to that inflammation part, that chronic inflammation is the bed ground for a lot of diseases. So we don't want to happen. And we are stewards of our body. And as stewards, we need to try to do all that we can to keep our body as much, to stop our body from being inflamed, to lower that inflammation level in our body as much as we can, and also to stop opportunities for our bodies to become inflamed. Okay, so here's the rule of thumb. Toxic. When you hear the word toxic, think man-made, synthetic, unnatural. When you hear the word non-toxic, think God-made, natural, minimally processed, okay? So that's where you are. If things are man-made, synthetic, unnatural, there's a good chance that there may be toxic to your body. If it's God-made, natural, it's a good chance it's going to be helping your body. Okay, so the question then becomes, what God-made things can you use more of when you want to clean or freshen your house or your body? And guess what, guys? They are out there. I know in the world that I grew up in, with the TV world and all that, we here see a lot of commercials about all these little products that they have, these cleaning products, you know, the personal care products or whatever. And you may think that that's the only way you can get things clean, that that's the only way that you can freshen things, is to use these products that you see in the stores and on the shelves, and you see the little commercials advertising it. But guys, it's not so. Guess what? You can find cleaning agents, natural, God-made cleaning agents, right in your pantry. And they're doing a double duty. You can cook and eat with them, and you also can clean and refreshen with them as well. You just need to know what they are. And here's an added bonus you're going to get. You can be saving yourself some money. I know that sounds good. You can save yourself some money because you're not having to buy all those other kinds of products. You are downsizing. Okay, so, and one more thing I want to add. If you have a garden and you're growing things like herbs and stuff, more money saved, because you can also use a lot of those to freshen and brighten, okay? And did you know, when it comes to your nose has a direct path to your brain. So when you're smelling things, guess where that's headed? It's headed to your brain. And that is not what you want toxic things to do. That's not where you want them to be going. And you know, in the world that we live in today, we're not going to keep all the toxins out. It's just now impossible. But our goal is to reduce the exposures that we do encounter. Just like cigarette smoke. These days, a lot of us know, most of us, I think, know that we should not be in the presence of cigarette smoke. Even if you're not actually doing the smoking, you're not supposed to be getting that other that smoke from the other people that are actually smoking. That is toxic for you. We know that. But did you think about, there's a whole lot of other chemicals, a whole other lot of toxins that we are inhaling and breathing that we don't avoid in the same way that we avoid cigarette smoke. And you know what? We should think about doing that as much as we can, because knowledge is power. You may need to start small. I'm not saying, you know, throw everything out and, you know, spend a whole bunch of money with it. I'm not saying doing all that. Do what you can. You may need to start small, but the point is to get started. Find out what you can do. Figure out, make some kind of plan how you're going to do it, and get started doing something to reduce that toxic load. Okay, so in your kitchen pantry, you have baking soda, or if you don't have it, you can go buy some baking soda, and you have lemon juice, and you have vinegar, and there's some other things that you can use as well to clean and to freshen. You'll be surprised how well it will do that. In swapping it out for those other products, use those natural products that are going to be helping your brain and not hurting your brain. Now, if you want to know more of what those things are, how you use them, what they're best for, what proportions to put with what and all that, got that for you guys. I got you in my research library, and it's on my website, keepyourbrainsharp.com. You can get free access to my research library, and I have a whole chart with a list of alternatives. I think the one that I put up for today was bleach alternatives. It's that they brighten and they whiten and they freshen and they clean and they remove stains, all that good stuff. Natural, God-made alternatives. So if you're interested in that, I'm happy to share. Just go to my website, keepyourbrainsharp.com, get access to that resource library, and start using things that are non-toxic to clean and freshen your home and your body, because your brain's destiny is in your hands.